Daniel Syiem's ethnic fashion house has been formed mainly because we want to associate ourselves with the heritage fabric of the of Rindia, which is from the state of Meghalaya. In English, it's called Airy Silk. So I work with a group of women weavers who are from Ri Bhoi district, and they belong to Umthangam and Persik village. The reason why Daniel and I have taken up this job at hand is because we see that as of now, weaving in its present form is a dying art. So we are a little afraid that, you know, we will lose this heritage or this culture that we are so proudly, you know, so proudly we see that it belongs from the state of Meghalaya. And if in the next few years, you know, entrepreneurs and even public and private sectors do not help or encourage our weavers, then I'm afraid that, you know, the entire weaving sector might vanish. So we want to encourage our women weavers, and we also want to help sustain their livelihoods. And definitely there is a social cause behind the formation of the fashion house. Why do I do what I do is because I have a passion first to help, you know, to develop my own home state. I have a passion to work in the farm and the non-farm sector, in the rural areas in particular. So why I do what I do is because there is a passion in it, a passion that I want to see my state in the world map, a passion that I want to see my women weavers also on the world map, and us as the people of the state and of this entire world appreciating the hard work that they, you know, that they undertake into creating such an exquisite fabric, and which is so much, you know, kind of prominent in the field of, you know, the textile industry. As an entrepreneur, be it female or male, the basic, you know, requirement that you need to have is passion and focus for the work that you want to pursue. When you are an entrepreneur and the kind of work that you pursue, you know, I feel that you need to have passion for the work that you want to pursue. You need to be motivated enough, and please remember that you are working for yourself definitely, but you need to help somebody else also out there. The pressure is more on women because we have so much more things to do. We're not just going for a 9-to-5 job, you know. I think we get up the earliest and we sleep the latest, and you know, most of the work is an unpaid job. But we know that it is productive for somebody else, and that is why we still pursue this work. And so as a female entrepreneur, I want to tell all the other ladies out there, and you know, even the young gentlemen who are looking at entrepreneurship as a form of employment opportunity, to please have passion for what you do, to please prioritize your work also, you know, like today I want to do this, tomorrow I want to do that, day after. So being a little fickle-minded will not really help you, and there are a lot of hardships definitely for entrepreneurs, but with dedication, with motivation, and with support from your family or friends, you can conquer all mountains. You don't have to worry about that. When we go on stage, you know, we don't talk about ourselves as an individual. You know, we talk about the weavers again. We talk about the state of Meghalaya. We talk about India as a very diverse country, which is multilingual and multicultural. And this is a proud moment for us, you know. We are very proud of our roots, we are very proud of our heritage and culture, and when people in the international level recognize that and they appreciate it and they come and congratulate us, we are taking a lot of people's prayers and blessings with us. And I think the rewards that we reap is not of Daniel and mine, definitely. We are just, you know, the mediators or the in-betweens really. So we feel definitely it's a proud moment, it also gives us a lot of pride. And it also teaches us to be humble at all levels, you know, because we still have a long way to go. And people recognize us because we are humble, not because we are proud. And because we carry ourselves with pride. And we are very sure of the roots where we are from. We are sure of the place of origin where we are from. And we always showcase it in that positive manner. So definitely for Daniel and I, the journey has been hard. It has been long. It has been tiring. It has been financially quite, you know, kind of depleting. But the rewards are such, you know, which are intangible. The fact that we know that we are responsible for somebody's smile out there and for somebody's, you know, increase in livelihood and income. That kind of reward and that kind of feeling is priceless.